RCT Geek. Faith, fandom, fun.
Christ said to love your enemy. So how do we do that? These scripture passages offer valuable insight. Additionally, the classic sci-fi book Ender's Game can give us a clue. This video will show clips from the movie, but best to avoid the movie version. It wasn't very good. Anyway, in the future, mankind just barely defeated an alien invasion. Now they are training child geniuses to become the next commanders. The main character, Ender Wiggin, is the best hope for mankind. He is a genius, but more importantly, he has a killer instinct that's balanced by a sense of compassion. This allows him to get inside the head of his enemies, to understand how they think, and to know why they do what they do. And yet his dark side allows him to use that knowledge against them. This becomes key in the climax, but it's best demonstrated in a part where Ender is about to be attacked by a bully at the military school he's attending.
What tired are you, Ender?
You know your father would be proud. Come to fight a boy in the shower with your buddies.
Go watch the door. Go!
Ender uses the bully's sense of pride and honor to even the odds of the fight, but his violent side ends up killing the bully. Later on in the book, we learn that Ender figured out how to defeat this bully by getting to know him, but in the process of doing so, well, this quote says it all. Feel free to pause the video and read the whole quote. This is the Christian takeaway. We love our enemies by getting to know them and understanding why they do what they do. This does not mean we can't disagree with them or we can't try and stop them from doing something bad, but it means when we get to know our enemies, how could we not do the Christ-like thing and love them and pray for them? The book is Ender's Game by Orson Scott Card. It's good stuff. Here's the obligatory request to like, share, watch some more videos, and subscribe. May the Lord be with you.